Before beginning assembly of the Hoist Mi-5 functional trainer, please take time to read the instruction manual thoroughly. Please compare the tools and parts with the list provided in the manual to familiarize yourself with the parts before starting. Assembly of the Hoist Mi-5 requires at least two people. The following tools will be required for the assembly process: a ratchet wrench, a 1/2 inch, 9/16 of an inch, and 3/4 of an inch sockets, adjustable wrench, rubber mallet, a tape measure, level, SAE hex key wrench set, lubricant, and two people. Begin the assembly by laying the base frame, part number 4, flat on the floor. Have one person tilt the base frame back while the other person inserts the guide rods, part number 20, and secures the hardware with parts number 78, 80, and 115. Then insert the slight upright, part number 5, and secure with hardware parts numbers 78, 80, and 115. Wrench tighten these. Place the base assembly, part number 4, back flat on the floor. Slide the shield mounts, parts number 30, onto each guide rod. Keep the tabs on the outside and the holes on the inside. Install a rubber donut, part number 69, onto each guide rod, part number 20. Apply the provided lubricant, part number 117, to the guide rods, parts number 20. Attach the carriage stop, part 53, to the base frame with a gusseting flange, part 42, on each side. Secure them using hardware parts numbers 88, 78, and 178. Only hand tighten the hardware at this point. Now lay the mechanical tube, part number 48, flat on the floor to install the counterweight guide before attaching it to the base frame. First, insert hardware parts numbers 92 and 78 through the front of hole number 9 on the column, and secure with hardware parts numbers 78 and 100 on the back. Wrench tighten. Ensure the counterweight guides, parts numbers 113, are facing up and insert the cable into the top of the counterweight and secure the cable assembly 59-inch LG, part number 13. Wrench tighten. Next, with the column still lying on the ground, insert the counterweight into the mechanical tube, part number 48, and slide it down until it rests on the bolt. With one person on each side of the column, raise it off the ground and place it in the base assembly, part number 4. While one person holds the column in place, the other person should secure the column to the gusseting flange, part number 42, using hardware parts numbers 78, 93, and 78 and 100. Place the front flange part 28 on the front of the column and secure it to the bottom frame with hardware parts numbers 93, 78, 79, and 100. Leave the hardware slightly loose. Place the bolt-on foot, part 41, on top of the front flange and secure with hardware parts numbers 94, 78, and 78-100. Adjust the placement of the bolt-on foot, part 41, until the plug bumper, part 68, is touching the floor. Now, wrench tighten the hardware on the bolt-on foot, part 41. You will now add the 200-pound weight plates, parts number 109. We recommend placing the weight labels on the plates prior to installing them on the machine. Starting with the 200-pound plate, install each plate. Make sure the plate with the weight pin attached is installed last. Install the top tube, part number 6, with hardware parts numbers 87, 80, and 78 on each side into the guide rods. Hand tighten this hardware. Install the pulley, part number 66, and the cable at the same time with hardware's parts numbers 92, 78, 21, and 100, and wrench tighten this hardware. Unscrew the pull pin on the carriage, parts number 11, and move it into position 5 on the column, part 48. Attach the cable to the carriage with the cable lock, part 25, and the O-ring, part 59. Unscrew the pull pin on the carriage, part 11, and move it into position number 7 on the column, part 48. Next, remove the hardware parts numbers 92, 78, 100 in the column and set them aside. Now install the gussets, parts number 64, onto the sides of the top frame, part number 6, and secure with hardware parts numbers 100, 78, and 93. Hand tighten the hardware. Uninstall the screws from the sides of the cable housing. Then pull out the cable lock eye and be careful not to let the spring fall out. Now slide the cable housing off of the ball shank and cable reducer and set aside the cable housing until later. Now pull the stress reliever out of the cable housing. Make sure not to pull on the cable, only the stress reliever. It does not pull out easily, but it will come out. Tape the ball shank and cable reducer together. Insert the cable into the arm of the Mi-5. Install the pulleys, parts numbers 66 and 65, and hardware parts numbers 89, 78, and 100 at the same time as the cable. Ensure the bolts are pointing towards the back side of the machine. Now install the cable and pulley part 66 into the base frame part 4 along with the hardware parts numbers 89, 78, and 100. Bring the cable upwards and install it into the pulley, part number 66, using hardware parts numbers 100, 78, and 89. Then install the jam nuts and the lanyard ring, part number 109. The ring is installed over the jam nuts, and install it onto the adjustable pulley mount, part number 16. Hand tighten the hardware. Bring the cable down the adjustable pulley mount, part 16, and install it onto the pulley, part 66, along with the hardware's parts numbers 91, 78, and 100. Hand tighten the hardware. Bring the cable upwards and install it onto the pulley, part 66, using hardware's parts numbers 100, 78, and 89. Ensure the bolts are pointing towards the front of the weight stack. Uninstall the hardware from pulley 66 in the pulley mount number 16. Set it aside for now so that the second pulley can be installed. Now install the cable around the second pulley, part number 66, and install the second pulley into the pulley mount part 16. Reuse the hardware that we removed in the previous step, hardware parts numbers 91, 78, and 100. And install it into both the pulleys. Then wrap the cable around the pulley part number 67 and wrench tighten one part of part number 89, two of 78, and one of parts 100 into the pulley part 67 and the top frame part 6. Now pull on the cable to lift the top plate of the weight stack, part number 109, up until there are at least 8 holes showing in the weight stem. Then insert the selector pin into the 8th hole of the weight stem. This will provide slack in the cable for steps in the future. Drop the arm down to the lowest setting to allow room to route the cable through. Route the cable through the back of the carriage and the pulley arm until you can pull it through completely. Now raise the arm to parallel. Add the pulley part 66 into the swivel arm housing part 7 and make sure to install it under the cable so the cable sits above the pulley. Secure it with parts numbers 89, 100, and 78. Now install pulley part number 65 into the same swivel arm housing part 7. And make sure to install this one over the cable, ensuring that the cable sits under the pulley. Secure it with hardware parts numbers 89, 78, and 100. Now remove the tape from the ball shank, part number 1, and the cable reducer. Put the cable housing that was set aside earlier back onto the cable reducer and ball shank. Now reinstall the cable lock eye assembly onto the housing. Then wrench tighten the two screws into the cable housing and the cable lock eye. Carefully hold the cable lock eye assembly together to ensure that the spring does not fall out. Now, while holding the top plate, remove the pull pin and lower the weight stack to replace the pin in the top hole. Now secure the side upright, part number 5, and the top frame, part number 6, with parts numbers 92, 78, and 100. Hand tighten this hardware. At this time, wrench tighten all previously hand-tightened hardware. Take time to assure that your unit is assembled square and perpendicular. Use a level to check that the guide rods are perpendicular in both directions. If they are not perpendicular in both directions, it will be necessary to loosen some of the frame hardware and realign the frame and then retighten the bolts. Now remove the latch assembly, part number 9, and set aside hardware's parts numbers 83, 75, 98, and the spring, part number 70, and spring anchor, 27, until later. Install the pulley, part number 66, along with the cable into the Mi-5 arm, part 17, and carriage, part 11, using hardware's numbers 89, 78, and 100. And make sure that the cable is threaded between the pulley and the guard pins. Wrench tighten the hardware. Now reinstall the latch assembly, part number 9, into the Mi-5 arm, part number 17. Reuse the hardware that was set aside earlier, part number 83, 75, and 98, and the spring, part 70, and the spring anchor, part 27. Wrench tighten the hardware, then loosen it just enough for the latch, part 9, to rotate freely. Install the push fasteners, part 61, into both of the panel trims, parts numbers 121, and the shield, parts numbers 46. Install both shields, parts numbers 46 and 47, onto the Mi-5. Insert the push fasteners, parts numbers 61, into the panel trim, part number 121, and the back of the shield, part number 47. Now secure the shield, part 46, to the top frame, part 6, with hardware parts numbers 81, 73, and 72. Then, secure the back shield, part 47, to the shield clip, part 50, on the top frame with parts numbers 81, 72, and 73. Hand tighten this hardware. Then secure the shield to the bottom of the frame by securing the shield part 46 to the shield mount part 30 on the frame and the clip-on nut part 50 with parts numbers 81, 73, and 72. Then secure the back shield part number 47 to the shield mount part 30 and the clip-on nut part 50 with parts numbers 81, 73, and 72. You may now wrench tighten all the shield hardware. Install the top cap 1, part number 39, onto the top frame, part 6. Then wrench tighten 3 of the bolts, parts numbers 81. the internal lock washer, part 73, and the flat washer, part 72. Then install top cap 2, part number 44, onto the top frame, part 6, and wrench tighten bolts, parts numbers 81, internal lock washer, part 73, and flat washers, part 72. Wrench tighten the low head bolt, part number 84, and the nut, part 98, into the top caps, part numbers 44 and 39. Install the cover, part number 29, onto the column, part number 48. Install the pulley, part number 66, one of part number 89, two of parts numbers 78, and one of parts numbers 100 into the carriage, part number 11. Ensure the cable runs between the guard pin and the pulley. Wrench tighten the hardware. Repeat this step on the other side of the machine as well. Install the tablet holder, part number 43, into the side upright, part number 5. Secure with hardware parts numbers 85, 77, and 76. Wrench tighten this hardware. Install the cup holder base, part number 40, and the cup holder, part number 37, onto the side upright, part number 5, and secure using parts numbers 82, 74, and 97. Wrench tighten this hardware.